Mamas, Pastor Cynthia here. I wanted to let you know that I'll be coming to you each week via video to bring some spiritual and practical encouragements to you during this time. You are my most favorite people in the entire world. Mamas are so important and they really do decide the temperature in the house. And you're kind of locked in your house right now, so it's so important that you are your best you. And I want to help you to do that. I want you to look back and say, I killed it during the most trying time in my life. And I believe that God wants that for you. I've been meditating on a scripture this week that I hope's encouragement to you. It's Philippians 4, 6, and 7. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your heart and your minds in Christ Jesus. How are we not anxious right now? How are we not nervous about leaving our homes? The way that we aren't anxious is by prayer and thanksgiving, to be thankful that we're able to be home, that we have a home to live in, that we have food to eat, that we have our babies. And I just want to encourage you that each morning to not be lazy in your devotional time, to get up early or split up the time now that your husband's home from work and let him watch the kids so you can spend your time with Jesus and spend that time being filled and ask him for a plan. I believe it's so important to have a plan for every day with your kids, a spiritual plan and a practical plan. Write those things down for your week and every day do something different with your kids. During this chaotic time, structure brings peace. And I want you to know that you can control that. That's something you can control in your life right now. So I want to encourage you. Some examples would be spiritually, teach your kids a Bible song for the week and teach them the hand motions and do it with them and have a little worship time with them in the mornings. At night, do a Bible story and pray with them and cover them with the Holy Spirit. You know, from all the junk in the world, they're walking around seeing people with masks and they're hearing things on the news. They're hearing conversation. Wash that off of them and pray for your children that God's bubble of grace will cover them and they won't be affected during this time. And he will honor that. I also want to just encourage you to have some fun. Ask the Lord for a plan for the week that each day you do a practical fun activity with your child. I used to love to make forts with my kids, which is why I'm sitting in this fort with you today. I wanted to encourage you this week to have a fort day. And during that day, break all the rules. Let them eat in their fort, let them watch movies, do their story time in the fort. Just let them have a blast in the front room, just destroying your house for a few hours for one day and having a great time. And you will look back and say, these were the best family memories ever. And go on a family walk. Or just get outside and do something different, you know? Do a garden day with your kids when the weather gets nicer, where you're teaching them to put their hands in the dirt and plant a garden. There's so many fun things, but make an activity and something spiritual and practical every day to do with your kids, and that will bring some order to things. I also want to encourage you to have your kids focus on others. You know, have them FaceTime their aunts and uncles and their grandparents during this time, or draw pictures and pop them in the mail to them. There's lots of things that you could schedule in through the day that your kids would have a blast with and that you can have some order in your day with them. So I just want to encourage you in that. I want you to know that during this time, you can text me or call me for prayer. If you want to send me prayer requests for your family, I will completely honor that. You guys know I will pray for you every day for whatever it is that you need. I'm praying for you already. And I want you to know that I'm here for you during this time. And I can't wait to spend this time with you every week and to just have some fun and encourage you. I love you, Mamas. You're doing great. And I want you to know that God sees you and you are making a difference in your baby's life. I love you so much.